欢迎回到《施诚有约》。李显龙总理宣布5月15号将卸下总理职务，正式交棒给副总理兼财政部长黄循财。
是的，那么李总理为何会选在这个时间点交棒？这将如何影响下一届的全国大选？马上欢迎新加坡国立大学政治系副教授庄嘉颖，您好。
主持人好，大家好。
是的，庄教授您好。那想请问您的就是，黄循财副总理正式被委任为第四代的领导班子领军人物，那距离今天刚好是2年的时间，总理选择在这个时间交棒，您认为原因是什么呢？那你怎么看这个时间点？
所以我们晓得就是这个大选呢必须要在明年11月进行。那在这个时间点交棒其实是5月中就让这个黄循财有一定的时间准备下一届大选，然后也让他有一定的弹性决定什么时候让大选进行，因为在新加坡的制度下毕竟执政党可以决定在某个期限内决定什么时候进行大选。
那么其实针对这点，我们稍早前也和政治观察家、新加坡管理大学法律系副教授陈庆文进行了一段访问，我们来听听他怎么看。
It comes as a surprise. I had anticipated that the handover would take place later this year, but it does suggest that there is some urgency in the handover, and I can only attribute that to the ruling party, perhaps looking at an early general election, perhaps after the National Day rally in August. So with the election being brought forward, then that requires, you know, the handover to be brought forward as well, because the new prime minister, you know, will need some time to reach out to Singaporeans, you know, to paint his vision of Singapore under his leadership, to win the trust and confidence of Singaporeans, you know, in the little time that he has, you know, before the next general election. So I think it's probably driven a lot by the deteriorating geopolitical situation. You know, so over the weekend, Iran launched its attacks, you know, against Israel. And I think, you know, the government's assessment, you know, could be that it becomes important, you know, before things deteriorate further, you know, for Singapore to have a new government in place. So I think that has, you know, brought forward the timeline. But it also indicates, you know, that in PM's assessment, DPM Wong and his team are more than ready, you know, to take over the leadership of the government and the country. So it's not that they are driven by external circumstances, you know, but more a question of, you know, the 4G being already for some time.
是的，庄教授，你刚刚也提到说，其实下一届的全国大选最迟必须要在明年，也就是2025年的11月举行。那黄循财上任之后呢，有可能会将大选定在什么时候，肯定是大家所关注的。那您刚刚也提到说，哦，在5月就完成交棒的这样子的程序，对于黄循财副总理来说呢，他可能会有一个比较有弹性来决定大选的时间。那庄教授，你怎么来看这些因素可能会影响大选的时间点？
其实大选时间点最主要是执政党他觉得有信心进入大选，他在某个时间点举行大选对他最有优势，所以给予这个黄多点弹性，就是可以让他决定什么时候在什么时候他可能认为最有优势进行大选。我觉得这个是一个活的一个项目，一个观察点，不是一个死的，不是一个定的。反正执政党他会有他的政治考量，他会以他自己的优势、他自己的利益作为出发点。
当然，针对下一届大选可能在什么样的时候举行，我们也来听听陈庆文副教授的分析。
I think, you know, with Mr. Wong taking over in May, we know that he will then deliver the National Day rally, his first in August. I think before that, we can expect a cabinet reshuffle because that will be his first cabinet. And I think, you know, we are looking at a possibility of a September general election because I think he will use the National Day rally platform, you know, to paint a compelling vision for Singapore and Singaporeans. And I think they will want, you know, to take advantage of this period. That period will also mark, you know, Mr. Lee Hsien Loong's, you know, 40th year in politics as well. So I wouldn't be surprised if, you know, there is this intention of profiling, you know, the change as well as continuity in the leadership of Singapore, right? Moving from Mr. Lee Hsien Loong, you know, to Mr. Lawrence Wong.
新总理上任下来，内阁可能会改组嘛？但是如果改组的话，哪些变动会成为关注点呢？我们再来听听陈庆文副教授怎么说。
Singaporeans would be very interested to know who Mr. Wong would appoint as Deputy Prime Minister. He could have one DPM, he could even have two, as there are now two DPMs as well. We also see whether you know, some of the older ministers you know, will be retired. We also expect to see you know, among the 3G leadership, you know, who will be asked to continue to serve. And I think that's where, you know, people will be keen to know what is Mr. Lee Hsien Loong's role in Mr. Lawrence Wong's cabinet. We're also looking at perhaps, you know, new political office holders. I think Mr. Wong would certainly have, you know, the succession from 4G to 5G, you know, being one of his top priorities.
好的，那下一段的十分访谈，我们会将目光转向中东地区。庄
教授将继续和我们探讨伊朗和以色列冲突升级，中东的局势下来会如何演变？不要走开。